Father, we thank you for allowing us to be here tonight to gather to discuss the work for the town. We ask that as we go forward that you would guide and direct us and help us make the right decisions for the town and its residents. We ask that our conversations be friendly and that you protect each one of us and keep us safe. In your name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome.
Good evening.
Glad to be here. Okay, let's start. Everybody got their copy of the minutes?
Yes.
Any recommended changes, modifications, anything?
I make a motion that the minutes for the two previous meetings be approved as presented.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Claims and warrants for signatures.
March end of the month claims, $406,804.96. April 15th meeting,
$205,834.67. You want to hand out for the signatures now?
I make a motion that the March end of the month claims for $406,804.96 and April 15th meeting claims in the amount of $205,834.67 be approved.
Second.
In favor?
Aye.
In front of you, little packets.
Payroll warrants.
Yes.
Yes. In the amount of $31,727.47. That's for March 25th, April 1st, 8th, and 15th.
Okay. A motion to approve those.
I'm going to go ahead. You're all right. I didn't hear you. Sorry.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Hi, Scott.
He'd have been here earlier if Kathy had let him in. We'll do the bank reconciliations. Utilities is $2,173,500.70. For the town is $1,088,857.31. Payroll $2,008.38. Customer deposits $34,430. I have a motion to approve those.
I make a motion we approve the April bank reconciliations.
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Okay.
adjustments. One water sewer adjustment, account 8109-14, Susan Cushley. And we got a billing adjustment of $49.97. Motion to approve.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
And that takes care of both of those. Now we go. Jimmy, hiding back there in the corner. What you got? What's this?
That's for you, present.
The quote for the electrical from Alley Electric to do the...
Electric in there, it's a lot more than... And it's pretty screwed up. We started on it, geez.
It says parts and labor to rewire an entire building, as well as add receptacles up to six. $3,571.04.
Hey, Jimmy? Did you ask it about hooking that sink and hot water heater?
He is going to wire to it. Somebody will have to hook it up. He'll install it and wire it up, but the plumbing...
And that's included in this price? The water heater?
Yeah, we have the hot water, we already got it.
Yeah, but I mean, that labor is figured in with this.
What'd you say it was, Jay? Right? Oh, sorry.
Parts and labor.
That'll work.
$3,571.04.
And that was all the electrical?
Yes.
There's supposed to be another quote, but they didn't get one in. So apparently, he knew he was supposed to have it in today.
He's without.
Yeah.
Anything.
I make the motion that we accept the, and move on.
Second.
As soon as possible. Did he give you a timeline, Jimmy, when he could start? Does it have one on there, Jay?
The only thing it says on here, the quote's good for 30 days. So I guess it'd be ready to start.
You guys haven't taken enough out where, does he still have power to his office?
Some power.
The light?
Not right in his office.
There's no receptacles that are powered. So we have no internet, no computer.
Are some of the other receptacles working where you can extend your cord in? No, I'm not.
Because I think they're all on the same circuit.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Just try to get him here as soon as possible, Jimmy.
Anything else, Jimmy? Okay. John?
I appreciate your support with the electrical, that's a big issue. Right now, the reports are not accessible without me moving my computer to somewhere and get power to it. So I don't have any numbers for you. I feel like a broken record. We're still waiting on that console. That's the only piece that's still missing for the Explorer. Once we get that in, he acts like that he'll be ready to go with it. Outside of that, the only real thing I'm working on department-wise is our standard operating procedures and getting them up to date. I'm speaking with a company called Lexipol now. And it would be all online at that point, which would be nice. But I don't know what kind of numbers they're going to give me when we get to that point. That's pretty much all I have this evening.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Terry?
Nothing.
Ma'am?
Yes, I'm Angela Slinger, and I know I haven't been to any of these meetings before, but I am, however, not a stranger to the town. My father lived here, Albert Esslinger, and I don't know if you guys, you remember Mike being the sheriff and all or whatever. Anyway, needless to say, I'm not the best citizen there is, and I get kind of loud, but I do care about, should I stand? Sorry.
No, that's fine. You're fine.
I do care about, you know, our earth, and I do care about the pollution and the kids, and I know I don't set the best example as far as doing things correctly, so that I may lead by that, but do you know where the, that holler is over there by Chuck Keller's? That big holler that's like...
Benson's Basin.
You know what I'm talking, okay, right there. And I would love to get all of that trash cleaned up, I don't know, just because I don't know if the town is interested in hearing anything like this. It's probably like a broken record with me, but since my parents have passed and my husband has, and I'm sure long before that, centuries before, there are things in the world that happens, and leaders try to prevent or try to bring together the communities, societies, and countries in order to astonish, you know, the citizens, or to save, or, you know, for whatever the prophecy may have, you know, revealed to them. But since then, someone and something, and a lot of which are speaking to me in a very profound way. And in the beginning, which was 2013, it was so profound. With that being said, my dad passing, I didn't know how to take it. I didn't know how to take the messages and signs that I was getting. And I thought it was fake, and I thought, you know, things were it was a lie, and I was crazy. And I thought that I could just go on continuing to hide the pain and stuff, and it'd be okay, it'd go away or what. In real, I've never experienced anything like in my life. It was like God speaking to me. And it was just amazing. Amazing the things that I have experienced here in Montezuma alone. And I mean that. I mean that. Clear down to when I was educated in school. I mean, it was just very different. And so I carry that with me when I leave. I carry us with me when I leave. And me and him, we get into it all the time. And I leave and I go, you know, to another state, and the pain and the pollution elsewhere is way worse than we could ever have. And I'm thinking, you know, it's just not like that in Montezuma. It's very beautiful. It's so beautiful here. The soil is so rich here that I don't cut through the grass because I think it's rude and I think it might kill something. So I just think that along with our energies and along with our heritage and our strength, and just from the feeling that I get and from what's being spoken to me, we have to clean up the earth. We have to clean up how we live. And I know I'm not one to talk, but God is like, if we're not living for Him, He wants to know how we're living, how we're doing it, what steps we're taking to get there. And to suffice, or something really bad is going to happen. So I think we're all doing excellent, besides interruptions here and there, besides that gully. And I'd like to maybe get the kids and help clean it up. I mean, I don't know. I can't go out there with the little IGA bag cleaning up all the trash. I'll be there all day and stuff. Very interested in doing so.
Yeah, that is private property.
I would never step on it without permission. I would not even... Yeah. That's why I'm here tonight, sir. Thank you.
But, you know, we can't give you that permission because we're not the owners of that property.
Right. The town couldn't, like...
All we can do is send out letters to property owners. That's the first step to do. But what she said, and she's right there, most of it is on the street side, blowed up against the fences, that's blowed out people's yards for... all year and winter, and It is there. So what I want to say, we've got, yeah, to the fence, you're right, Nick. Here in a little bit, we're going to do something. So we're going to have a part-time worker starting soon for the town. So that could be one of his projects, go down and pick up the trash along that fence.
I'd love to be his assistant of some sort. I'm also, I heard from Jimmy down by the railroad trestle that they are looking for summertime help to mow and things like that. And I wouldn't want to send a letter up to the owner saying it's rude.
Well, we got to, because that's just part of it, because no one, it ain't rude, because they, it's their job to keep their properties clean.
Who is it?
I don't know who it is.
It's a man from Indianapolis.
It's nobody local.
Oh.
Nobody local.
It's not a local person.
Is it the same one that took over Cobb's trailers up there?
No.
Same Indianapolis man?
No.
No, we've been in contact with him before. But there is a group called Montezuma Pride. And if there is a job like that in town that needs to be tended to, they will get together and help do things like that. They have gone in and helped people's homes who...
Not able
to clean them up, and they've gone in and helped them. So there's not been a lot of publicity about it, but there is a group that does that.
Awesome. Thank you for letting me know about that group.
It's,
I just think it's important for us. I feel like it's important for us. It's really laying heavy on me, and it's not letting me let go of the importance of the collection everywhere. So that's why I wanted to bring it up. I mean, not that we're lazy or we're not doing our jobs or whatever. It's just important to our health and futures.
Yeah, but anything laying along there up to the fence, and like I said, I mean, anybody can pick that up to inside the fence. That's, you can't go in there.
Yeah, we have, I mean, if you want to do that, we got utility bags up at the town building and garbage bags. And
awesome, thank you.
All right.
Thank you. Paul?
Okay. The park board did meet Sunday finally, and we're trying to move forward, but trying not to spend money at the same time, because we don't have anything coming in until October when we have the Franks in the park. But one of the things we're looking at is replacing the veterans' memorials before, hopefully before July 4th anyway, when we have a program up there. But City Welding has, I think that's what it is, has showed us what they can do in cutting out a Marine Corps emblem and stainless steel, and then backing it with a solid piece of stainless, and then they'll set it with three legs, and set it down in concrete, right where the old ones were, and it'll be level with the concrete. Mighty nice looking thing, but we don't know yet. They haven't given us a price. And I won't say what we voted for a certain amount. If it's not over that, we're going to go ahead. But we don't have any idea what they're going to be. But they're really going to be nice when, if we can do it and get them all done. Dink saw them and Terry saw them. Saw him, I guess. But that's one of the things we're doing. And we're trying to, I think we are going to raffle off one of those Blackstone grills and start selling tickets for that and see if we can generate a little money. So, and give it away October-ish, I think, is what we said. So, and that seems to be one of the hot items right now, is the Blackstone grill. So, I think that's all I have. I think we covered. Parks in the Park is Saturday night.
October 30th.
October 30th. So.
Are you talking about burying the cement where them ones?
Yeah.
Yes. That week. Yeah.
That, the ones that's there is the third set, I think.
I think so.
Maybe it's the second set, and we've already got the third set bought in concrete. And Annie's got them stored in a baseball shack over there. But they just won't last, the concrete ones. Hard to believe, but they won't. They just erode away to nothing. So we're going to chip them out again and start open. The last time we even put them in and...
Poxied over and...
Poxied over, thinking, we got it.
Sealed the top.
What we're going to try to focus on a little bit is cleaning that area up and making it look presentable again. It's okay, but okay's not good enough on that. So that's where we're at. That's what the rule says for the park board. We meet every, the first Sunday of the month at 4 o'clock, unless it's holiday, you're welcome to come.
I guess we are having a military ceremony to honor veterans on July 4th. That's coming up before the October.
So, there's nothing, is there anything on Memorial Day?
No.
No, nothing, not that we know of, there isn't.
I'm done.
Thank you. Yes.
Will there be a parade and things like that this year for the board?
No.
Nothing like that's planned or anything?
No.
Fire department's got right around 58 runs for the year so far and counting. We had a meeting with a E1 representative on Sunday evening. I've been waiting on the quote back on that for a new truck. We just received a few quotes actually from some other manufacturers. Aaron Fox, which is the manufacturer of the last truck we bought, they're ranging anywhere from $385,000 to $440,000. And then I received another quote from Rosenbauer, which was around $430,000 as well. So we're going to wait to see what E1 gets, and then we're going to have to come up with some money somewhere else. So just throwing that out there, unfortunately. And then I'm working on the inventory list for all the trucks. Should start that here probably this weekend, or hopefully it might take a couple weekends to get them all done. But that'll give us a line item for everything that we've got on each truck in the firehouse, the rescue boat, and the hazmat trailer.
Are we downsizing the truck any?
It's going to be, I think we're going to get as long, it'll be roughly the same length. It'll be a little narrower, 4 inches roughly. That's pretty much going to be your standard size truck anymore, especially for the custom cab or custom truck. About 96 to 100 inches wide. I think it's about it.
Thank you.
Do you know if it's in the works for that equipment to be ordered, to be replaced?
I didn't get word from Kurt on that. I'll find out. Try to get back with you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, in your packet there is a letter from USDI with the agreement. The letter stated exposed the agreement amount of $25,000 per year. Here is 2021, 2022, 2023 and payable in quarterly payments. And then also during that, the retainer fee of $175 monthly will be omitted from that. Just want to look in there and see what they're going to do. And this has also been sent to they went to USDI and it was sent to the.
The letter behind that was sent to Pipeline Safety Division.
Yeah. Anyway, there was a. Must do to get in total compliance with everything going on with the gas. And that's all in the works. Hopefully it goes well. Okay. Any questions, comments?
I've previously made my comments in private, but as a town council member, I think I need to publicly say that I am very disappointed in our utilities that this has happened. And living through a death caused by a gas mistake in our town we don't need to let these things go, and we don't want to have to live through this again. And I live here, and I trust the people who are given the responsibility of taking care of these utilities so that I can live here safely and comfortably and know that my family will be here, be able to live here comfortably too. And I know that this town is paying those people to do their job and to keep their certifications up and to keep our town in compliance. And I am very disappointed, hurt, and mad that this has taken place. And I just want that to be known publicly. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ronnie Bailey has requested to attend training through the Rural Water Alliance on June 17th in Huntingburg in order for his continuing education credits. And that's on a Friday?
Thursday.
Thursday. Okay. And then he'll be taking Friday off. And he and his wife going on a little vacation. And the question is, mileage to and from training?
I make a motion we pay his mileage. We do for everything else.
Yep. Okay.
And he's going to school for us.
Yeah.
Aye.
Aye. Yeah. You got that, Gabby?
You got it. Say aye to me.
Yeah, right.
And we copy in the packet of the emergency management for Parke County.
I copied you in the fire department. It's from emergency management and want to know if we were looking for a request for equipment training or exercises that would help with your agency's ability to respond to a hazardous material incident. So if you guys know of anything that you'd like to put in for... Because while our budget is limited, any requests, and they were unable to...
They would be more apt to know what it is we need.
Yeah, that's like giving you guys a copy of our future.
Chris is a little very knowledgeable about his emergency management.
Yes.
Last time I was over at the partnership meeting, he sent some stuff over, some manuals and stuff for us to use. Okay, also in the packet there is a quote from overhead door for the replacement of the operators and the remotes at the firehouse. This is just mainly information of what kind of money we're talking about for the 2022 budget. We'll take a look at that and keep that in mind.
Is this something we should include in next year's budget?
Yes, that's what the information is for. 7% increase coming in 30 days.
Okay.
So we'll have to. Kathy has provided us with the list of violation letters sent to seven.
They need to be sent.
And there's seven that's listed right now.
These are just on mobile homes. Yeah. Terry Lou and Lee, the chauffeur, I think, went around and got a list of all the mobile homes in town. We took the computer to see which ones have utilities on and which ones didn't. That's why the little footnotes are on that list I gave you. But these definitely are in violation. We need to remember if they don't comply, then that 30 days.
We've got to do something.
We've got to do something.
And that can be quite expensive.
Yeah.
We have to remember.
I saw down here, the first trailer is east of John Penn's, not the one running east and west, but the one running north and south. They're coating the roof on it today.
Which one?
The one, the one that...
Like Stark's set like this. Yeah, are you talking about the one behind those?
Yes.
Where the skirting's removed?
Yeah.
And they coated the roof today?
They've got ladders on both sides and coating the roof.
Did you happen to see who was there?
The plane boys turned that one down.
That's what I thought too.
Bill McLean is?
Why did they coat the roof too?
You say they started coating the roof?
Uh-huh.
I see ladders up there, but I didn't see no one around.
A person that thought they owned the trailer had sold it to somebody else and they were going to be moving it out.
Oh.
I mean, either way, that would solve our problem, but...
Last I knew, the cops still owned both of them.
That's why, yeah, I gave Scott copies.
They didn't own the one.
We checked the tax records and the property cards.
Yeah, as far as that, but one of the brothers had sold it to the people that rented it prior. I know, but...
I think we have to go by what's on the record.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I was just going to...
I make a motion to send the letters out and we'll do the best we can to keep a backbone and get it done.
I second.
They also, as they went around and got a list of the trailers, they checked the properties out in town and made a list of what. So when I get time to detail that more, we might want to wait and see how we have to respond to this first before we go.
You got to start somewhere.
Yeah.
And these are priorities.
So these ones that are empty and nobody has lived in for over a year, we have to send a letter out.
Yes.
It's due process.
Same, in 30 days.
Okay.
Motion's made and seconded.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Bob?
I'd like to thank all the volunteers. And then Jimmy, thank you guys for up there in the cemetery. That looked so much better with them old evergreens out of the way. That's it.
I already mentioned, we've already discussed the fire truck and the fact that we need to include it in next year's budget, and that was my concern, was where we were going to get the money for that. So that was my only thing.
The firehouse.
The fire truck.
Oh.
The doors, what do you?
Oh, well,
yeah,
that
we
too.
Have, we'll get the
that
other.
And
yeah.
The fire truck,
yeah.
Both the fire truck and the doors, the door openers rather.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that would be two things we need to make sure we include. That was my only thing.
You're confused.
Well, I'm not confused, but we'll have to wait and see what that last quote comes in as, and you might have to consider this year's budget.
For the fire truck? Okay.
We should have that probably by Thursday of next week.
Because how long did it take last time?
The quotes that we got, a few of the trucks will be ready in May, and then a couple of them will be ready in November. So.
And then are we still looking at trying to file the grant to help, or no?
Yeah, we're going to have to back to rural development, or...
We didn't really use it, because we paid down to a certain amount on the fire truck. So, didn't you say rural development?
Yeah, roll
just going to roll this over into... So it would be the difference in this and what the price of the actual new truck would be.
Okay.
And they were just going to roll this
over. Oh,
so
they will roll
it
once. Okay.
Ah.
But
okay.
They're not loaning this anymore, but then we just continue to...
Use what we have.
Pay on that, and they'll roll
the okay.
So basically that's better.
Got to wrap that up then.
Right.
Okay.
Are we clear to go ahead and buy that extra equipment?
Well, the subcontractor, I'm not changing subjects here.
I'm sure the money we received for the damaged equipment.
Just rolling it over.
$27.
I'm glad I said something.
We need to go ahead and get that ordered because we need to be able to recoup our replacement cost on that. And it needs, I need an invoice by the end of April, the first of May for sure, for us to be able to do that. That's why I keep bringing it up. Whatever he turned in to be replaced, that's what had to be ordered, and it can't be used for anything else. It has to be what was claimed damaged.
I have nothing because I clarified that and we talked about it.
It was a $28,424. And then if we get the invoice for that and turn it in, we'll get like $3,400 back for recoverable depreciation.
Yes, there is a.
It's an insurance $29,000. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I'm glad I said something.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
No, thank you.
Where are we at on the water tower? Do we need to have a meeting so we talk to these guys to see? We're in limbo right now, aren't we?
Well, if I remember correctly, we left it that we're going to have to come up, we're going to come up with like a down payment on it.
Right.
And then we'll have to give him those figures, and then he will refigure everything from the get-go with that figured in.
But we're waiting to see about that.
Maybe that's something we could try and tackle at the projects meeting next month, going over. I can spend a little time with Kathy, get some numbers from Kathy. And it's not quite Pat Callahan level, but I can do some rough estimates of what you can do and what the impact would be. So he did email, I know he emailed everyone pictures and everything, and he's supposed to email me a copy of the agreement that they used to have seen. He did email me back, he said he'd get me one. So so we can make sure that it's all kosher. You know? But, and I don't, you know, the numbers are the big part that I think we all want to know about. So it would be helpful to sit down with you guys and decide how you want to do it. You do have some money saved here and there in water, excuse me. But you also have to be careful to not,
careful with
you know,
yeah.
Well, like we got all this, let's throw it in there, and then a pump goes out at the wellhouse, and so.
Percent needs to stay, but, right, percent needs to go out.
So you want to talk about that on May 6th then, when we have our project meeting?
Mm-hmm. Okay. He's waiting on us to get back.
Yes. Yeah. Although I probably need to get, that makes me think I don't just need a blank. I probably need to get him to send me like some number stuff, like you know, show me roughly what, he roughed out some numbers, but I don't have those.
We told him that we had X amount to show us the payments.
But I'm trying to see how they structure it there, so I'm trying to understand it. So if he sent us like what he had, and then we can use that as, okay, that's the baseline. Mm-hmm. If we, I can, it's just a calculation. Rough it out and figure out if we put in $150,000, what does that do to your annual payment? I might be off, but big question is how much could you put in, and then what's your annual payment going to be? Then we have to look. Okay, your annual payment's going to be $50,000. What's your
payment?
I got a new car payment I got to make. I already got this payment to make and this payment to make, and I got to pay. Can I make that $500 a month car payment, or do I need to make $300 a month car payment?
Yeah.
Do we need to meet before May 6th?
We can.
I mean, so he could go ahead, because what maintenance he has to do could have to be done pretty quickly.
If you want me there, that would work out a lot better than the 6th, because I have I have to be somewhere.
Okay.
The 5th and 6th.
Okay. Well,
fine,
that's fine.
Just kind of thing where we know where, basically, when Scott can get it together.
What do you think would be a good date for you, Scott?
Next week, I've got, I already have three nights of meetings next week now.
Well, as long as we notify the paper.
Last week of April, that last week of April, I don't think I have.
Probably make it.
Any.
The only night in the last week of April I can meet would be Monday night, but the rest of the time, I'm good.
Plus, I need to get up, and Kathy's got the number here, but I would want to double check some stuff with her. So we could try and meet that last, let me look at my, oh, I don't have one.
And take a date for you, Dan?
Check his date, you guys check your dates and then.
Okay, any night but Monday for me, I can meet.
Last week.
Yep.
Call me.
No, yeah, that last week, I don't have anything to eat.
Tuesday, Wednesday.
Yeah.
But next week's not.
Dude, what'd you say, Shauna?
They said no Thursday, you said no Monday, and I don't think it's gonna be on Friday, so we're down to Tuesday, Wednesday.
Tuesday, Wednesday, I can do that, either one.
I ain't going nowhere on Friday.
Yeah.
Unless there's a baseball game.
Baseball game, see?
But the most they've been on Thursday, I miss them on tonight. Yeah, I don't, whenever.
Tuesday.
Just call me and I'll be here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll send you an email.
Put it in my file.
I'll send an email to your mailbox.
Ain't been going in that far. I called the girls in the morning, see how they're doing.
There you go. See if it's safe, huh?
Anything else there? Kathy?
Let me have the paper, okay?
Oh.
May first, yeah, we won't have a meeting.
So.
Make the motion. And we've got the project.
We received two applications for the temporary help, and we decided to make the offer to John Wild. And we'll see when he can start. And it'll be $12 an hour on the dates, no benefits.
That'll be pending proof of driver's license and.
And drugs.
Drug screen, yep.
Yep.
We need a motion to.
And if it don't work out, move on to the next application.
So somebody want to make the motion to do that?
Yep. Have the back part, remember his name. I make the motion to hire John Wild for the part-time position, starting as soon as possible.
Second.
Drug screen.
On favor?
Aye.
Okay.
I did forget to mention one thing. The townwide cleanup is Saturday, May 1st, from 9 to 4, and there will be two 30-yard dumpsters in the utility yard on that date, and it'll be 9 to 4 or until the dumpsters are full. So tell everybody you know.
And that stuff out of their yards and stuff, not cleaning their house out and hauling. Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
Tiffany.
I do have something. I'm Tiffany Sinclair. Moved in last July, lived at the corner of Washington and Pine. I walk the dogs in a little park that we have just on the other side of Water Street, and I've noticed at the end of Pine and Water, right there where they come together, there is a dump that people, I don't know if it's city people or who it is, but they've been dumping gravel, big concrete. Chunks of concrete. There's now a countertop in there.
Oh.
The countertop was not supposed to be put in there, but concrete and fill dirt, we're trying to fill that hole again.
Okay, awesome.
But building materials and stuff wasn't supposed to, but any concrete, people shoveling up dirt, gravel, yes. Because we'll keep shoving it. That's been a hauler for several years.
Okay, that's what I was
wondering. And it was privately owned, but then when the town took it, when.
Okay.
Government done that.
Because I've talked to the gentleman that owns the, he calls it a cabin, but it looks like a two-story garage.
Garage, yes.
What's his name? John. I've talked to him, and he's cleaned out those stairs that go down to the water.
Yeah.
And so he and I were talking about that, so I told him I'd try to figure out some information on that so I can let
him know. We go back so far, we'd like to, my opinion, we'd like to see where people don't have to walk out on the street to walk through the walking trail. So if we can get it back so far, that would be smooth, and they could just hit the walking trail and without coming out to the road, and then back in.
That'd be good.
I did have one question for Scott. Were you able to contact any surveyors or anything like that?
You just would have waited, Terry.
He got to him, yeah.
I don't say what I'm thinking.
Yeah, Jay ain't asking.
I talked to the surveyors in Crawfordville. I need to get them some things. They seem more, I wasn't talking to the surveyor. I was talking to the assistant. She, I don't think she knew, really understood what I was talking about there. But I told her I'd get her the maps that we do have. They wanted to see those, and then something showing where we wanted to do it. I have emailed, or had emailed me back today. I was emailing her, giving me Matt Boris, who's an engineer, or surveyor at Myers Engineering. And he said they'd be happy to look at it. He said they actually did this for Rockville. So, and someplace else, maybe it was Roseland or something. But I'd be curious to see if Rockville was happy with it and how much it cost Rockville, because that might be a good indication of what it would cost Montezuma. It's okay, I don't have any numbers. So.
That's fine, please, moving along.
Okay, Kathy, were you done?
Yes.
Scott? Do your regular thing now.
If I missed it, I think we ought to vote just to, for minutes, that this contract with USDI is approved.
Okay.
I don't think that was... We talked about it, but...
Okay, can I have a motion to approve the contract with USDI?
Make the motion.
Second.
On favor?
Aye.
That's it. Well, I expect I talked about it.
You're up, Nate.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.